Hi there, welcome to Mini Math Lessons with Karen. And today I am going to be showing you how to enter functions or graph functions, how to graph the inverse and then the identity function all in one so that you can see the symmetry of the inverse functions. I'm going off of two activities and using the CG50 graphing calculator. But again, what I do in this calculator, you can also do in any of Casio's graphing calculators. The nice advantage of CG50 is its color, and so you can really distinguish between the two, or however many graphs you have. We're going to have three. So what I wanted to just kind of talk briefly about the activities, because they're really nice. So these are two different activities, both that have to do with inverse functions. But you'll notice this is the first one called Tsunamis. And has a little situation, but then the problem itself is talking about earthquakes and how they cause tsunamis, and the students end up with a formula, an equation for the velocity of the waves as a function of the depth of the water and the gravity, right? Gravitational constant. So they're going to be working with this function here, and they're going to be finding answers based on this. So the really nice part is you have this function, but it's related to a real world situation, and they can kind of talk about what the equation means in context of that. So they're going to write the equation, and they have two different ones. They have 32 feet and 9.8 meters per second. So the first question basically is, if we're using feet, what's the equation? So to graph that equation, I'm just going to quickly show you over here in the calculator menu oriented. I'm going to go down to graph, and I'm going to hit execute to get me into the graph thing. And let's delete the function that happens to be there right now. And I want to enter this graph. This is the equation. So y equals, and they're giving me the gravitational, but they're not giving me h. So my equation would be the square root. So I want to use, if you look over here, here's x squared. It's inverse. The square root is right here. So I need to use shift. And that gets the square root symbol in there. So 32x, all right? So that's the equation. So when I hit execute, let's just see what the equation looks like. And so what they see, and if the window isn't nice enough, we can change the window. Maybe we want to see, we probably want to see negative 2. And so I'm changing the window. I'm just, let's say 12. And then my y values, let's make it be negative 2 again, but let's go a little higher for the max, so let's make it 12 also. And now we're going to go back and try to draw and see if we can see it. Okay, so we see it a little bit better there. So there's the graph. Notice it's just the positives because it's a square root, right? So that's the function, and they're going to use that function to answer some questions like what's the y-intercept, what does that mean in the context of the situation. So they're going to be doing a lot of those types of things. And then as we get down to the last part, they're going to say, well, can you make the inverse function of that? And what I love about this activity, and both the activities in fact, and I'm just going to kind of go through the solutions, is that when they ask them to find the inverse, when we ask to find the inverse, they are doing inverse operations versus what we tend to tell students is, oh, switch the x and the y and solve it for x, or solve it for y. Instead, what they're doing is, let me just show you. So they have this function, and I can't, square root of 32 times x, right? So that's the function they have. If we think about what's happening to the x? Well, it's first being multiplied. So we're going to multiply by 32. And then that answer is being square root, right? Square root. So if I want to build the inverse, I want to basically do the inverse operations with inverse numbers in the inverse order. So what is the inverse of multiplying by 32? It is to multiply by the reciprocal, 1 over 32, and what is the inverse of square root? It is to square, right? But I want to do them in the reverse order. So I want to first square my x and then multiply by 32. So my inverse function would be y equals x squared, so we're going to do that, all over, so this whole quantity is multiplied by 1 over 32, so that whole quantity then is over 32, or 132 times x squared. So now I've built my inverse by using inverse functions. So that's what I kind of really love about this. It's showing them that you're not just doing a process, you're really understanding an inverse is the inverse operations in the inverse order with inverse numbers. So now let's go back to our graph, and now let's put in our inverse function. So it is going to be, again, x squared, and I want my quantity all over 32. So there's the inverse, right? So I'm going to hit execute. So what I want you to notice is the first original function's in blue, the inverse function's in red, and I'm going to put in this green line here, I'm going to put the identity function, which is y equals x. All right, so now I have three functions. I'm going to hit draw. And the reason I'm doing that is when you do that and actually graph them together, you can see the symmetry of these functions. And so if you hit the trace button, and let's, pick a, so I have five, I was going to try and get to a really nice number, 6, 1.125, and now let's go up to the inverse function. Why isn't it letting me go up there? There we go. And let's see if what 1.125, if I can actually get there, is pretty close to 6, right? So it's kind of helping them figure out, and you can look at a table of values for each function and kind of compare what's the difference between the original and the inverse. What do you notice about the input, output, the independent variables and the dependent. So what I love is the visualization that you can do, and the color on the CG50 is really nice. So that's the first activity. The second activity is sort of the, not the same obviously, but same idea. You have a function you're going to be looking, this is an exponential function, and you're going to be graphing that, and you're going to then do the inverse again. And let's get back here, and let's leave the x, because we're going to be using the same thing here, but let's delete these functions. So delete something, you can hit delete, and then it asks, do you really want to do that? And you say, yes, I do. And then, or you can also hit F2 here, and then yes, I do. So now I want to enter my other functions from this activity here. And I'm just going to scroll down and kind of show you, this is an exponential function. So very simple to enter it, 650, and it was times 0.75 raised to the x, right? So there's my exponential, and if we want to see what that looks like, it's a bad window. Let's go back to draw, and we probably definitely want to change our window. See if we can actually see something here. Does it recommend the window? Yes, it does. All right, let's go recommend, and it wants us to start at 0. And we want a max of 24. Oops. Darn it. Sorry, I'm making a mess here. Oh, we can almost see it because I forgot to put my y values. So 0 and 700. So yeah, we have some large numbers in here. So we need to make our output be much larger. So 700. Here we go. And now when I hit draw, I'm going to see it. Okay, so there it is. Exponential. You can see it's exponential decay, right? And now I want to do the inverse. And so think about this. And I'm going to go back down here just to show you because it'll be a lot faster. So when we're trying to find the inverse of this function, we're going to do the inverse operations with the inverse numbers. And so this is something being raised to an exponential. So the inverse of exponential is the log. So that's what's going on here. So we're multiplying by 650. The inverse of multiplication is multiplication by its reciprocal. So that's where this a over 650 or y over 650, how are you going to think about it. And then the inverse of raising to the x power is to take the log. And so that's what's happening here. And again, I just love that it's using inverse functions, but let's go back in and enter that inverse function here which is really interesting looking. So we're going to put the function in first. And you know what? I'm going to make this a little smaller. Here we go. And I want to put in the log. So here's my log button. And I want the log of, and again, a function. So a is my x over. So I'm just using my arrows to get myself down in the numerator denominator section. So now I want to go down over here and I want log again of 0.75. So there is my inverse function. I'm going to enter it. Now watch what happens when I draw. It's a little hard to see again because of our window. I'm trying to think what a good window might be. Okay, so I've been playing around with window. I paused it and I'm back. So a good window is because, you know, where they're intersecting is very, you know, low down. So we don't need to go up as high as 70. So the suggestion in the activity is to start with a window of 0 to 50 for both, scale of 1 or 10. So I did that. You'll see I've changed the Y min to 0, the max to 50, put a scale of 10. So then when I hit exit and I've put the Y equals X, the identity function here. So now when I hit draw, because I changed my window, you actually can see where the graphs are now, and you can see the symmetry of them. So this identity function is a line of reflection. Here's the original in blue, and here is the inverse of it, and they reflect each other, which is really nice to see. And again, you could trace the points. Remember, you can toggle between the graphs by just hitting the up or down arrow controls here. And if you're in a graph, you can then actually move points, and you can see points as if you go left or right, you can see specific points on them. And then, so the activity has them exploring, you know, what does a point here on this graph mean? What's the matching, you know, what's that mean on this graph? So they're really kind of in context looking about what the inverse and the original function actually mean in the context of the situation. So have fun exploring that.